No, no.
I'd like to call the meeting to order. Is there a motion to adopt the agenda?
Jenna, I have something for you to do.
First of all, I sent out an email to everyone, did you get that? That asked if you wanted to add anything to the agenda, did everyone get that? So, I think we can vote on that, but that's why I sent that out, was to, you know, so you would do that early and then we could have.
Well, it's like 3 minutes, 3 or 4 minutes, it's not that much.
Does anyone have a problem?
As long as we're not rehashing the same old thing.
What's the topic? What's the topic?
The topic is our board.
Okay. Does anyone have a problem with adding?
Why don't you take a, formal vote on it?
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do.
That would be consistent with our rules.
Make your motion.
Oh, I'd like to make a motion that I make a addition to the agenda for 3 minutes at the top of the agenda to discuss the topic.
Okay, Jody has made a motion, is there a second?
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries. Number one, Jody.
Okay, I've got some concerns here and I think I'll just read this. When I joined the South County Planning Commission last year, I was thrilled to volunteer my services to help our county and our community. It has been an eye-opener and rewarding experience, and unfortunately a troubling one as well. I've enjoyed working with my fellow members on the Planning Commission and enjoyed the good company. However, as I have served, we have all borne witness to a problem that has only become more apparent with each month that we serve. That problem, as I will discuss, is that our chairman has repeatedly demonstrated her inability to run our meetings in accordance with Georgia law, and more critically, she has eroded the ethical line that must be drawn between us and the developers. In fact, our chairperson's ethical line has eroded to the point where she has voted on matters where she was legally required to recuse and then reaped enormous personal financial benefit in return. I present this evidence with a heavy heart and with even more latent concern that I have only seen the beginning of a pattern that is unraveling before our eyes. Despite her 14-year tenure on this commission, our chairman has continued a pattern of violating Open Meetings Act, exposing each member of this body to potential civil liability, criminal liability, investigation by the Georgia Attorney General's office, as well as calling into question the validity of any actions taken by the South County Commission as a result of our recommendations. Pre-meeting meetings of selected members of this body are a blatant violation of the Open Meetings Act and run roughshod over the ideal of open government. More troubling, this pattern of illegal behavior has repeatedly occurred. Finally, and most critically, the chairman's impartiality is no longer redeemable after a series of votes by her on matters involving Riverbrook Capital Partners, LLC. By the chairman's own admission, she has received compensation from this now defunct and bankrupt developer. Yet, in violation of our rules, she has voted on well over a dozen matters involving Riverbrook without recusing as required by law. But more, even on the three few matters for which she did recuse herself involving Riverbrook, because in fact she received compensation in the form of at least a tennis court and a gate, The minutes of our meetings reflect that she actually and remarkably voted on some of these very matters. The recusals were not even done properly under the law, being devoid of the required conflict of interest affidavit in our minutes, and without satisfying the other recusal requirements under the county and state laws. To this day, our chairperson has remained mum over the value of the compensation she has received from the defunct developer she endorsed in her motions and votes. In addition, the chairman's property tax records indicate that the box to be checked if there's a tennis court on the property is not checked. These shady dealings with a developer have garnered negative publicity in the statewide media outlets and harsh criticism from statewide ethics groups. This body must change course to maintain the credibility of this body, and indeed, the Forsyth County Commission itself. Changes must be made. Period.
Does anybody else want to comment?
I actually would just make one comment. There was a statement in there that mentioned running the meetings in accordance with Georgia law, and I take it that our staff and myself personally are responsible for that. So one particular example of a recent meeting we had to cancel was the fault of the staff, myself personally. I'd just like to clarify that point.
And the three times that I recused myself, I did that per what I was directed by staff to do.
Don't blame the staff.
I'm not blaming anyone. I followed the direction of staff by recusing myself from three zonings that I had compensation on. And that's what I was told I was to do.
Well,
and I did
clear,
what I was to
it's
do.
It's clear in the ethics manual and in the law. You know, it tells you exactly what you're supposed to do. And it doesn't say go ask the staff.
And we are directed by staff because we are lay people.
Okay.
We have always been directed by staff.
Well, no, we're directed by the law for the state of Georgia.
Via the staff. The staff directs us on how we are to conduct a meeting.
Okay.
They sit and help us along with how we are directed,
okay,
just as every chairman has since I've been on this board for 14 years.
I know, and that's why I'm surprised.
And I have not been the chairman for
14
years.
This is not a personal attack, by the way. It's just, it has to do with running the meetings and accepting compensation without proper recusal. And it's nothing personal in it.
The recusal was done exactly how I was told to do the recusal, how everyone prior to me and since me has done their recusals. And that's all I can tell because, that's all I can say because that's what I did.
Okay.
It's per what I was directed to do.
Yeah. Well,
and I was given a form to recuse and that's what I did. So what are you asking for, Jody?
I'm not sure. I just want to notify everybody of how I feel, and that I don't think that we've been.
So are you? I mean, what are you saying? Please give
well,
me the bottom
right
line.
Well, this right here, a conflict of interest. When a member of the Planning Commission feels this is Forsyth County Planning bylaws. This is our bylaws. And you're the chair. When a member of the Planning Commission feels he or she have a conflict of interest in a particular application, the member shall immediately undertake those disclosure and abstention actions as required under Section 14 of the South County Code of Ethics, as well as action required by the OCGA 3667A-1.
And I did. I immediately recused myself from every one of the three zones.
Well, there's more to it than just recusing.
Were you not above board before this even occurred with everyone
no.
on the board?
Yes. Always.
You're supposed to say in there why you're recusing yourself.
And everyone on the board knew exactly why I was recusing.
Right.
And the staff did also.
Can I?
The law contradicts.
Can I suggest that maybe we move to have this discussion at the end? Take care of the business for those people here who are trying to take care of matters before the body, and then we can come back to this item, you know, and let it be discussed, but at least have the respect for those people.
Yeah, I don't know.
By putting that at the very beginning, you're not having respect for those people, and it's just not right.
I understand.
So can I move to push this item to the end of the agenda?
Second.
All in favor? Motion carried. Agenda item one will be moved to the continuation will be moved to the end of the agenda.
The amended item one.
The amended item one.